Over the last year, we've seen some really cool technical developments from SRAM on the bikes of some of the world's fastest and best riders. In particular, that elusive black box wireless transmission setup. Now, black box is a technical development program used by SRAM and Rockshox ultimately to refine and bring to market very specific products. Now, I've been waiting with bated breath because today is a really cool day for mountain bike tech. SRAM AXS is finally here. Luckily for us, we've been able to work with SRAM in order to get the full technical lowdown on the world's first wireless electronic transmission for mountain bikes. Like all technical kit, products like SRAM AXS take many years of development and testing, and we've seen several incarnations of the SRAM AXS system over the last year alone, including the setup that we've seen on Nino Schurter's bikes. We've seen several different options throughout the year, but there's also been setups spotted on Emily Batty's bike. Mitch Ropolato was running a Reverb post, electronically operated, at Crankworx earlier in the year. And we've even found out now that Yaroslav Kolhavy was actually racing and riding the electronic stuff years ago. So you've got to love a bit of secretive development. But enough of that stuff. Let's take a look at the production SRAM AXS setup. So let's start at the cockpit of the bike with the Eagle AXS controller. Now, sitting underneath the bars, much like a traditional gear shift lever, the AXS controller is very neat and very ergonomic. Now, you might note that I'm referring to it as a controller and not a shifter. Now, I think it would be strange to refer to it as a shifter given the fact it's a fly-by-wireless type device. There's no cables, there's no mechanics involved in this. But there are six notable points with the AXS controller. It's wireless. Well, this is pretty obvious, but look how cool it is. Look how minimal and neat it is. And it's very quiet too. Now, you don't realize how much noise your gear and transmission cables make when they're just rubbing and knocking against each other until you suddenly remove them. So the main paddle itself. Now, although very different to a regular shifter, its position and shape is actually very logical and very intuitive to use. There's two touch points, up and down. The sprint paddle, or as SRAM like to call it, the secretive sprint paddle. Now this, you can nudge with the knuckle of your index finger without removing or releasing your grip on the bars. This is an absolutely amazing feature for those downshifts when you're really sprinting under power. Think the run into an XC World Cup finish line or maybe the end of an enduro stage when you're absolutely guns blazing. Dun, 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 dun. That's the way. Fully customizable. Now, the beauty of a controller system is that you can assign any of those touch points to do exactly what you want them to do. You don't have to stick to it in the default settings. It's kind of like shortcut keys on your camera or your keyboard, or even just customizing the face on your smartphones. You get all the apps and stuff exactly where you want them. Really, really cool. Power. Well, it barely uses any power because it's just a controller. It's powered by a small CR2032 battery, the type that you see in a lot of watches. It powers down when it's not needed and it's going to last 2 years. And lastly on the AXS controller system is the pairing button. Now, simply this is so you can pair it up with other components within the AXS ecosystem. And it also means that you do have the ability to adjust trim in a very similar way that you would with a barrel adjuster on a traditional cable setup. Next up is the Eagle AXS derailleur. Now, although the controller is very cool, the derailleur is actually where the brains are. Now, despite how much tech is crammed into this unit, it's actually very simple to set up and even more simple to use. Visually, the Eagle AXS derailleur shares a lot of similarities with the conventional Eagle mech, but there's actually quite a lot of details that are quite significantly different. The cage itself is 10mm shorter, and the actual position of the upper guide wheel enables the chain to have increased wraparound on that cassette. And of course, the battery unit itself is mounted on the back of the derailleur. It's out of harm's way there. The battery lasts for 20 hours, it takes 1 hour to charge, and it's compatible with all the other batteries. They're all the same within the AXS ecosystem. You can hot swap these batteries too, so there's no messing around of having to repair anything. You can literally take the battery off and plug another one straight on. If you are unlucky enough for it to run out when you're out on the trail, the derailleur will stay in the last used gear. Of course, you can just swap in a battery from your Reverb and continue riding. And yes, of course, it's completely waterproof too. So there's no issues at all with riding and racing in foul conditions and jet washing your bike afterwards. Now the units are designed to withstand up to IP69K standards. Now that's the sort of stuff that construction gear, we're talking drills and stuff you see on building sites, has to adhere to in order to be used outdoors in demanding conditions. The only thing you have to make sure of is the battery is either on or you have one of the blanking plates in place when washing your bike. Now, as far as adjustment goes, there's three main points of adjustment on the derailleur. There's the B screw or the B tension screw. They're the same as any other derailleur for setting the height of that upper guide wheel in relation to the largest sprocket on the cassette. Now, there's also upper and lower limit screws. Now, although it's a good idea to have these properly set, the controller will only enable the derailleur to move within specific limits. So actually, it's not that much of a problem. The only other adjustment, of course, is the pairing button, which is used in order to pair with the controller and other components within that AXS ecosystem. It's also used in conjunction with the controller if you need to adjust the trim at all while you're out on a trail or any other time. Shifting is absolutely instant. It's so fast and so punchy. It doesn't matter how much load is going through that system. Bang, bang, through the gears. Much faster, much punchier, and much more predictable than a conventional system. Now, as far as noise goes, the mech makes some really cool sort of electronic zippy noises, but really the whole system doesn't make any noise at all. Just think, when the clutch derailleur first came out, it was a game changer, and now it's like that all over again. Now, probably the coolest feature, as far as I'm concerned, on the AXS rear derailleur is actually a protection system. So it's called the overload clutch. So there is already a clutch unit on the lower sprung cage in order to help with chain retention and keeping things quiet. But the overload clutch is specifically there to protect the motor. So if you were to strike the cage on, say, a rock or in a crash, something like that, you could damage the motor if the clutch wasn't there. Now the clutch simply disengages everything and allows the cage to move out of harm's way. And a few seconds later, it will return back into the position you were in before that impact. That's smart. And of course, there's the reverb access as well. So this is a brand new seat post from Rockshox. It's the Rockshox Reverb Access, and it's wireless as well. It has its own dedicated controller up at the bars on the left-hand side there, which, like everything else, is customizable. We'll get to that in a minute. Now, the seat post itself has a brand new IFP design. It's a low friction design. It's far lower friction than previous seat posts by Rockshox. And it's also got a couple of other really cool features and some slight differences. Now, one of those features is vent valve technology. Now, at some point, you or one of your riding buddies will probably have been unlucky enough to have the dreaded bounce in a seat post. Now, what happens there is effectively air gets the wrong side of the IFP and it results in you having to have a service to get your post sorted out. Not anymore with the vent valve technology. You simply remove the post. Using that vent valve, you can effectively bleed that air out. You compress the post, put it back in, good to go. There's no adjustable return speed now. So one of the features the Rockshox Reverb seat post has been known for is having that effectively a barrel adjuster to adjust the rebound speed of the seat post as it extends. Now, of course, most people would run the seat post at full speed because you want it to be reactive in the way you want to ride. So Rockshox have done away with this. It's not needed and it's set at the factory on the fastest setting now. And I can tell you, it feels faster than before, more predictable than before, and the action is phenomenal. Now, as well as being an electronic operation and being wireless and all the other stuff, the thing that's so outstanding about it is how instant you can drop that seat post. Now, whether you're using a hydraulic Rockshox Reverb or you're using a cable operated post, there is a delay when you engage the lever or the drop lever in order to actuate the seat post. On this, there is no delay at all. You literally tap that button with the tiniest bit of effort and it's infinitely adjustable within its travel as well. Well, of course, it's wireless. So this is a true plug and play seat post. None of that internal routing faff that really does give you rage in the workshop. You can plug and play, you can put this on any of your bikes, nice and easy. Of course, the controller, super easy to unplug using a matchmaker system and bash on another bike. Now, as far as battery goes, it's the same battery as you see on the rest of the AXS system, which means you can swap them around. It's hot swappable like the rest of the system, taking an hour to recharge, and it lasts between 40 and 60 hours of use, depending how trigger happy you are. Now, the clamp design at the top of the post is very different. So in order to house the motor and the battery system at the top, the previous twin bolt system could no longer be used, so I had to go for a single bolt system. Single bolt systems aren't always the best, but Rockshox have refined this. Now, the single bolt on the side is purely there to clamp the system down. There's also another bolt at the front which adjusts the pitch, so there's no slipping with this system. And finally, the last thing is the controller itself. So there's a dedicated controller that sits on the left-hand side of the bars with a single paddle. Like the right-hand unit designed for the derailleur, it's incredibly active, it's super easy to use, it's really minimal and in the exact place that you want it to be. But the cool thing is, like the rest of the AXS system, you can have it your way. You can assign it to different levers and different functions, something I'm going to show you about with the app. If you use the app, then that really unlocks the potential of what you can do and what you can imagine this system is going to be able to do in the future. Now, the app's a fairly simple thing to use. You open it up, you pair it with the system, you put in all your rider details like your name, your bikes and all this sort of stuff. And if you have various different systems, you can name them and assign different things to them. Now, using the app, this is the super cool thing. You can assign any of the paddles and touch points to do different things. Now, for example, the dropper post controller sits on the left-hand side of the bars, but you don't have to use it for that feature. You could have this set for downshifts and have the right-hand paddle set for upshifts, and then the top part of the right-hand paddle, that could be operating your dropper post. Just think of the opportunity for how you can customize the setup to really suit the way you want to ride the bike. Super cool. Now, who is it for? Well, immediately the thing that stands out to me that this has been designed for ultimate shifting performance. It's not just tech that's been developed for the sake of making it wireless. This is to make shifting better, more positive, and of course, ultimately customizable. Okay, sure, it's not cheap by any means. It's not trying to be cheap. This is a premium product and it really does sit in that superbike category. So there's two models in the range. There's XX1 and X01. XX1 is aimed firmly at the cross-country racers out there, and it has titanium hardware on there and it has a carbon cage. Now, the X01 is aimed more at the enduro rider or someone that wants something that little bit more robust. It's got full stainless hardware and aluminium, a forged aluminium jockey wheel cage on there. Now, the XX1 transmission is actually about 70 to 80 grams lighter than the original 11-speed SRAM XX1 transmission, and it's about 15 grams lighter than the Eagle XX1 setup, whereas XX01 is about 5 grams lighter. So what does the system cost? Well, obviously there's various price points for various products here. So the Reverb Post itself, that retails for about $800. The XX1 transmission retails for $2,100 and the XX01 at $1,900. Now, is it compatible with other AXS components like the road stuff? The good news here is yes. Anything is cross-compatible within the whole range or ecosystem of AXS components. So for example, you could have the AXS Reverb seat post, put it on a gravel bike, and you could use those little blip box little buttons you can get on the road equivalent of the AXS system in order to operate it. Now that is super cool. Now again, something else so exciting about this is what the future holds for things like the wireless AXS system. You've only got to think that how your smart devices, your phones, your watches, your devices on your bike, how they're all going to start interacting together and learning and gathering data. This is super cool and super interesting, not only for being able to customize everything, but for what sort of scope there is for future developments. Now, I'd imagine that the data gathering is going to start analyzing sort of things like your shifting patterns, the gears you use most. It might even be able to make recommendations on the best size chainring for your bike, for your power and what you use. I think this is just incredible, and this is only the start of something. Of course, the app is going to see loads of firmware updates and alterations as time goes on, and there's surely going to be further products that are compatible within the AXS system. If this is what the future holds for tech in mountain biking, then I am all in. I love the fact it's adaptable. I love the fact it's customizable. I love the fact it learns things as you're using it. I think it's really intuitive and it's a very, very smart piece of kit. But I'd love to know what you think of SRAM AXS. Make no mistakes, this is a super high performance product. It's not designed to be there for everyone. It's not designed to filter down to budget price points. This is the ultimate, the premium thing. Let us know what you think of SRAM AXS in those comments below and we can pick up that conversation. Now, if you want to see what Neil's got to say about it, check out his video over on GMBN right here. And if you love what SRAM are doing, give us a huge thumbs up and don't forget to click that subscribe button.